mobility trainer. I've been working with her for about a month now in order to improve my shoulder pain and my hip tension, and it's really helping me get more control over range of motion and giving me a lot more confidence and comfort in all of my workouts and day-to-day functionality. So I'm gonna let her kind of explain what we're doing today.
Hi, I'm Sophie. I'm a NASM certified personal trainer. I have FRC and kin stretch as well. We are gonna do some CARs, which are controlled articular rotations, which is basically for joint health. It's controlled joint circles. We're gonna do shoulder CARs, hip CARs, and spinal segmentation, also known as cat-cow, but we're gonna slow it down. And we're gonna do hip internal rotation, which you see a lot on Morgan's Instagram because it's one of the very important ones for hip health, prevents back pain or helps get rid of back pain, helps with squatting, running, sports, changing direction, things like that.
Perfect. So yeah, you guys can just swipe through to the next portion of this video and take a look at all of the different exercises.
So we're going to start with shoulder CARs. We're going to basically go through the full range of motion of your shoulder, keeping it packed down. I never want you like reaching to the ceiling or anything like that. So you're going to take a breath in, abs nice and tight, straighten your right arm, bring it to your side. Up, nice, slow, and controlled. Once you step the top, you'll start to rotate and reach behind you. Bring that hand to your hip, palm straight up, and then start to unwind. Nice, slow, and controlled. We'll do one more. Palm straight up to the ceiling. Good, start to come out and rotate. Reach, reach, reach all the way behind you. Normal if you hear any cracking or popping, as long as it's pain-free, you're good. Let's face it that way. We're gonna give you a little side view. Palm straight up to the ceiling. Out a little bit. Bring your rotate and reach behind you.
Really, I think it cracks.
Straight up. Rotate that ankle behind you, together, and then other hip and possibly from shoulder to shoulder, which is normal. It's likely how you sit at your desk, how you sleep, things like that, previous sports as a kid. So to get in 90-90, find that bony landmark of your hip. Your knee is gonna go straight out, and then your ankle is gonna go straight from that knee, creating 90 degrees. And then same thing for that back leg. And then you're gonna face that back leg. So Morgan's gonna face me to get into hip internal rotation. She's gonna try and let that, her right hip go as close to the floor as possible, trying to get that glute to touch the floor. You'll probably, again, have a difference from one side to the other with this.
All of this hurts a lot more than it looks like it does, but in a good way.
Yes, you're gonna feel a stretch here, which is normal and good, means you're probably in the right position. If this is too hard, you can lean on something, you can put your elbows on the floor, there's always regressions. From here, you would stay here for a couple minutes, and then you would gradually increase the press of your back ankle into the floor. 20% effort, 30%, all the way up to 60% effort on the first set. And then sets thereafter, you can go up to 80%, then 100%. And then after you do that isometric pressing into the ground for 20 to 30 seconds, then you're gonna do the opposite. You're gonna try and lift your ankle up, keeping this hip where it is. Your foot is likely gonna come up, which is a good thing, that's totally fine, but your ankle should not come up off the ground because you want to be at your end range of motion. If you're not at your end range, that means we're not gaining any more mobility. You would do that for about 10 seconds and then you would relax, take a few deep breaths, and then you would do that again, isometrically pressing into the ground, building that up for 30 seconds, and then trying to lift again. You should see all of these muscles kind of flex as you're trying to pick up your ankle. You might cramp in your outer hip, which is okay.
These at home, be sure to tag us, let us know how you feel, document yourself doing them, we would love to see it. And if you are local to Chicago, Sophie offers classes as well that you just started doing.
Mm-hmm. I'm now offering 6 a.m. on Tuesday mornings, 6 p.m. on Wednesdays, and every other Sunday at 9 a.m. at Hi-Fi, located at Orleans and Institute. I hope to see you there.
Yeah, and you can always DM her or DM you with any questions that you have.
Yes.